Just upon returning to his apartment from jogging, aspiring Mage Knight and flunking Heigun Academy student Ikki Kurigane inadvertently walks in on a half-naked girl changing in his room. While being admonished and forced to apologize by Academy Director Kurono, Ikki learns that the girl is Stella Vermilion, a famous A-rank blazer who is the princess of the Vermilion Empire and his new roommate. When Stella announces a set of house rules which Ikki objects to, Kurono has them stage a mock battle, with the loser having to obey the winner unconditionally. Ikki accepts despite the disadvantages of being an F-rank blazer, stating that he has to work hard in order to win the 7-Star Sword Art Festival. During the mock battle, he demonstrates powerful fighting skills and memorizes Stella's technique, which he uses against her through his technique Blade Steel. As a last resort, Stella activates her Noble Art, but Ikki counters it with his own Noble Art, outmaneuvers her attacks and strikes her, winning the battle but collapsing from exhaustion. Later, Kurono visits Stella and explains that despite Ikki's strength, he flunked the Academy's evaluations due to his peculiar style. She then recommends her to follow Ikki's style so she could improve. Returning to the apartment, Stella apologizes to Ikki for her behavior. He then reminds her of the deal they made, for the loser to obey the winner from now on, and then orders her to be his roommate and friend. Ikki's younger sister Shizuku, whom he had not seen in 4 years, arrives at Heigun Academy as a new student. In class, Ikki and Stella learn about the selection match for the 7-Star Sword Art Festival from their teacher Yuri. Afterwards, they meet Shizuku, who surprises them by kissing Ikki directly on the mouth, leading to a duel between Stella and Shizuku over the former's relationship with Ikki. Shizuku tries telling Stella to stay away from her brother, inadvertently revealing that the Kurigane family treated Ikki as if he never existed. The following evening, Shizuku meets her roommate, the effeminate Nagi Alice Arisuan. Meanwhile, Stella asks Ikki about what Shizuku said. He explains to her that he was born without any talent in a family that produced great blazers. As a result, he was neglected by his family and later ran away and got lost in a blizzard, but was rescued by his great-grandfather Ryoma Kurigane, who encouraged him to believe in himself. Afterwards, he strove to become just like Ryoma and was accepted into the academy, but when the Kurigane family discovered it, they pressured the school, which was under the previous academy director at the time, into creating a set of class requirements which were responsible for Ikki's failing grades until Kurono became the new academy director. Though Kurono is also pressured as a result, Ikki then states that his constant harassment will never come to an end. After training with Ikki, Stella tries asking him out on a date, but their conversation gets interrupted by a text message sent by Shizuku, asking Ikki to go shopping with her. Stella is shocked when Ikki accepts the proposal and decides to accompany him. During the shopping trip, Ikki has an awkward first meeting with Alice, whose effeminate personality puts him off, but he later praises her for getting Shizuku to open up to other people more. The entire trip is spent with Stella and Shizuku competing to get Ikki's attention, with Shizuku seemingly triumphing every time. As the four split up to use the restrooms, the mall is suddenly taken hostage by a group of armed men led by a blazer named Bisho, who demands a large ransom in exchange for the release of the hostages. Kurono authorizes Ikki and his friends to use their devices to attack the assailants. When Stella intervenes, Bisho subdues her with his device Judgment Ring, and then forces her to undress in exchange for the freedom of the hostages. Shizuku takes advantage of the gunman's distraction to protect herself, Stella, and the hostages with a wall of water, while Ikki slices Bisho's left arm off to prevent him from using Judgment Ring. When the gunmen retaliate, another blazer Shizuya Kurihara arrives and subdues them. Afterwards, Kurihara reveals that Ikki had a match against him but ran away, and says that he will be Ikki's first opponent. During the selection match, Stella, Shizuku, and Alice easily defeat their opponents. Meanwhile, Ikki begins studying Kurihara's noble art, which renders him invisible and makes it difficult to even detect him using the other senses. Ikki meets up with Alice and confides in her about his match against Kurihara during the previous school year, when the Kurigane family still had influence over the academy's superiors. Kurihara had been harassing him with his device, and Ikki refused to fight back, believing it would be used as an excuse to expel him. In the next day's match, Kurihara starts off by activating his noble art, which covers the battlefield in an illusory forest. At first, Ikki is able to deduce Kurihara's location by observing the visible arrows he fires, but Kurihara uses a new, improved technique he developed which also allows his arrows to become invisible, injuring Ikki. Kurihara ridicules Ikki by saying that he must win the festival in order to graduate. Enraged, Stella stands up for Ikki and tells him to continue fighting, using everything he learned about Kurihara's attacks. A rejuvenated Ikki pinpoints his location with his noble art and defeats him, then collapses from exhaustion. At the hospital, Ikki is met by Stella and he confesses his feelings for her. Initially embarrassed by the confession, she then kisses his cheek. The two then promise to meet and fight each other in the final match of the festival. 2 weeks have passed since Ikki's battle with Kurihara. Ikki has progressed through the following matches with ease, quickly losing his school nickname of the Worst One and gaining the new nickname of Another One and becoming popular with the other students, volunteering to mentor them in perfecting their strength using what he learned about swordsmanship. However, Stella becomes frustrated when Ikki isn't paying enough attention to her during the time since they became a couple. Ikki later takes her Shizuku Alice and his followers to the local swimming pool for more training. There, Shizuku and Alice discuss about the former's affections towards Ikki despite their biological relation. Meanwhile, after talking about her and Ikki's relationship to classmate Kagami Kyuzukabe, Stella and Ikki get into a fight after she reveals her misinterpretation that Ikki no longer likes her, which he quickly denies. After the two cool down and settle out their problem, Ikki suggests they both blurt out what they want to do right now with each other, and Stella agrees. When the two both want to kiss, they happily do so. On the way back, Ikki and Stella are informed that their next opponents are members from the student council. As Ikki and Stella continue to make progress in the selection matches, Ikki notices he is being stalked by a female student, who eventually identifies herself as Aes Ayatsuji, the daughter of Kaido Ayatsuji, a famous swordsman. She had been hoping to ask Ikki to help her improve her swordsmanship, but was unable to approach him directly because of her fear of men. He agrees to help her, to the surprise of both Stella and Shizuku. During training, he deduces that Ai's problem lies in her imitation of her father's style, which is impossible to accomplish. He then proposes that since she is now fully dedicated to imitating her father's style and cannot utilize any other technique, she must adjust her position by understanding her anatomy. With this advice in mind, Ai's is able to land a hit on Ikki with ease. While accompanying Ikki and Ai's home, Stella asks Shizuku if she is jealous of Ai's, and she replies that she isn't, then hopes that Stella will always take care of Ikki and never betray him. One night, while having dinner with Aes, Ikki and Stella meet Kurato Kurashiki, a blazer who knows Aes and despises swordsmen. He begins harassing Aes and then injures an unresisting Ikki when he stands up for her. Afterwards, the trio is approached by Yutakata Misogi and Kanana Totokubara, members of the Heigun Academy Student Council, who commend Ikki for not retaliating against Kurato. As they walk back home, Ikki and Aes are informed that their next festival opponents will be each other. The following night, Ikki meets up with Aes on the school rooftop at her request. Aes and Ikki meet on the rooftop, only for Aes to jump off, prompting Ikki to use his noble art to save her. Aes reveals that she planned to prevent Ikki from using his abilities during the match since he can only use it once every 24 hours. Now weak and exhausted, Ikki somehow makes it back to his room where Stella, who is having a perverted dream, awakens and helps Ikki. Now Ikki has to fight Aes without his abilities and on a battlefield rigged with traps that Aes set. However, Ikki, who has learned why Aes is so determined, still wants to help her regain her pride. Despite sustaining serious damage, Ikki is not only able to see through and defeat Aes' technique to win, but also to break through to her and offer his help so that she could regain what she has lost. Accompanied by Stella and Aes, Ikki goes to Aes' family dojo and challenges Kurashiki to a duel to reclaim the dojo. As the fight progresses, Ikki takes some damage from Kurashiki's Orochimaru, reminding Aes of her father's fight with Kurashiki, which hurts her internally. When Aes wants to stop the fight, Stella stops Aes, telling her that she won't be able to get the dojo back if she does, and that Ikki is actually having fun and enjoying the fight, just like her father did. Ais then realizes that the apology her father gave at the end of the fight was to Kurashiki for not being able to execute his final move and collapsing midway in the match. Using Ai's father's secret technique himself, Ikki wins the match and restores the dojo and the Ayatsujiyo style to Ais. Later, Ai's confesses her foul play to the school and her father regains consciousness in the hospital. The director sends Ikki and Stella to a training camp. Stella is initially excited, believing she now gets to spend some time alone with Ikki, but it turns out they were sent to help the student council with cleaning up the training field. After cleaning, Stella insists in climbing up the mountains to view the waterfall with Ikki despite having a fever. Caught in a sudden storm, they take refuge in an abandoned lodge, and Stella's soaked clothing leads to an embarrassing situation to stripping her. Later, they're attacked by a puppet user Blazer who controls golems, but the attack is foiled by the student council members while student council president Toka to do herself deals with the Blazer. Meanwhile, Shizuku returns to the Kurigane mansion to face her father and learns that her next opponent will be Toka to do. Shizuku versus student council president Toka to do. Ikki and Stella are worried because they've seen Toka's power for themselves. Shizuku is determined to win to prove that she's strong enough to stand beside her brother against everyone, especially the Kurigane family, but Toka is calm and collected. As the battle progresses, Shizuku realizes that Toka is faster and stronger than her, so she opts for a defensive weapon and long-range water ice attacks. She covers the arena in ice to give herself a terrain advantage, but Toka is able to see through her attacks. When Toka demonstrates the ability to instantly close the gap with her trackless step, Shizuku fills the arena with a thick mist to use her final attack against Toka, but unfortunately loses the match to Toka's attack. The ethics committee, which is controlled by the Kurigane family and Akaza, creates a scandal by photographing Stella and Ikki kissing on school grounds. Ikki later gets arrested and is placed in a special prison owned by the Kurigane family, where he is continually interrogated and forced to fight the selection matches even while being imprisoned. Despite the odds against him, Ikki continues to win his matches. During one of his hearings, he appeals to speak to his father, which to everyone's amazement is granted. However, his father tells him to quit the selection process. If Ikki wins, he would cause unrest in his father's organization by inspiring those without magical ability to aim higher. Ikki is distraught that his father still refuses to acknowledge him. However, Yuri Sensei slips him a lock of Stella's hair, reminding him of his promise to fight Stella in the Seven Star Sword Art Festival. The ethics committee inform Ikki that his final opponent in the selection matches will be Toka to do, and if he loses, he will have to give up his dream. Ikki's final match against Toka to do is to be televised to the whole world. Stella and Alice win their final matches and spots at the Seven Stars Battle Festival. Even though exhausted and wounded from his prior matches and ill treatment in prison and haunted by self-doubt, Ikki arrives at the arena in time, cheered on by everyone at Heigun Academy. Toka to do, as well as everyone else, knows that the fight is fixed, but still wants to test Ikki's resolve to fight for the weak. Ikki and Toka decides to use all their power in just one shot. Surprising everyone, he defeats Toka to do, shocking Akaza. Refusing to accept the outcome of the match, Akaza tries to attack Ikki, but Stella runs to his rescue and easily knocks off Akaza along the way. As Stella is near him, he proposes to her while it was still being broadcast to the entire world. Then the Emperor of Vermilion telephones Ikki's father and suggests that their children should not be burdened by their parents' political goals. A ceremony is held honoring the school's six representatives for the Seven Star Sword Arts Festival, and Ikki is named the leader and flag bearer by Toka to do. Ikki is later seen talking with Stella about his proposal, but before anything can happen, Shizuku and Alice arrive. Shizuku proceeds to create new rules to teach Stella how to become a Kurigane bride, but this further enrages Stella, who believes some of the rules are made up and retaliates with her own rules. So this is the end of anime. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you enjoyed it.